welcoming back the U.S. government and Stephen Guilfoyle here on Wall Street. Stephen, did you miss the government?
Well, not really, but you know, I guess to stabilize markets. Well, they stayed stable the whole time, but to keep markets stable and to get the president off to Davos where he really wants to go, then I guess we have to get the government rolling again and get these people back to work.
Yeah, it's so true, but like Wall Street really didn't care, but isn't this looming X date kind of concerning?
Well, you know, we had a nice little pop in the markets today. We made a little bit of money. If we do this again in 2 weeks, I'm fine with that.
Well, you are good at managing losses, right? So let's just jump into his GE and Schlumberger. How do you make that to our viewers?
Well, thanks for mentioning my General Electric. all right. Last year, I had a tough position in Apache. I had to manage it through the options market. It ended up settling into a range. Throughout most of the second half of the year, it traded between 40 and 45. And once you recognize the pattern, once you realize where the algorithms come in, you can take advantage of this by buying it around 40 and selling it around 45. Now Apache's up around 47, pushing towards 48. Remember, this is also a natural gas play, not just an oil play. On a rising trend line, I know it's a little technical, but if it breaks through 48 within the next 2 weeks or so, that will become support. And then Apache's off to the races. We're already looking at a decent gain in this thing because of the way we managed it going into the year end. And it's starting to look like General Electric is going to be my Apache for 2018. I've already tried to manage this thing as it declined through the options market, through selling options, through selling puts and calls. Now, selling the puts didn't work out so good because I got run over. So now I'm along a lot of GE, you know what I mean? So I've sold even more calls, even more than I own. We've lowered the cost here. We lowered our cost basis down to about 19 and change. So we're not really that far off. It's trading a little above 16 last I looked, but this is going to be a tough one. This is not going to be one we get out of quick. We're going to have to stay the course on this. If it breaks down from there, then we probably got a problem on our hands. But you know what? The sum of the parts is probably about 15 or 16. How about Bank of America today, huh? Downgrading GE. Hey, thanks, guys. Well, where the heck were you?
They always do that at the beginning.
I'd rather just be quiet if I was that analyst.
Well, thank you for your honesty. And you know what? No, really, thank you for your honesty. This is what our viewers need to hear because a lot of people are long GE, right?
Yeah, no doubt they are. And you know what? Even though they can't afford it and the pension fund is a little underfunded, it still pays a nice dividend yield, even at half of last year's rate.
All right, so there's some uplifting news. Also uplifting, earnings. Lots of companies reporting this week. What major positions do you have that are reporting?
Oh, boy. Well, we just saw Halliburton, right? I don't have a position in Halliburton, but I do have a long position in Schlumberger, a nice one. And between the two of them, this is very interesting for the energy sector. Schlumberger is reporting, well, for one, Schlumberger has been very honest all along. When the whole energy sector was about to go into the toilet, they were the ones who told you. They were the ones that were honest about it up front, and they took their lumps with everybody else. Now they see the energy market is largely rebalanced, the oil market, and they see a premium attached to actual, I can't say scarcity, but there's going to be a tighter inventory levels going forward, at least in this country, and probably globally. They see probably production ramping up four times as fast in the U.S. as they do overseas. That doesn't portend as well for them as it does for Halliburton. I would like to get long some Halliburton, not on today's run, but I would like to be long both of them going forward because I think as long as you get some support here, maybe down a couple dollars in each of these, I think both of them can really take off. And with Nat Gas, Apache's another energy play.
All right, Apache on the backy.
You know what? Defense is going to be interesting this week, and so a lot of the tech names, a lot of the semiconductor names, Intel, KLAC, which is my best call for 2018, by the way, and Lam Research, which was my best call last year. All right, you got a lot of these semi plays and the guys that make parts for the semis. So this is going to be a very interesting week earnings-wise.
Cool. It's also going to be interesting economic-wise, right? I like Stephen in 2018. He's like really pumping it up. But listen, you are Econ IQ as well. We have Davos kicking down while they're drinking schnapps in Switzerland and such. And we also have the ECB and BOJ. What do we need to know, Sarge?
All right. I guess by April, we're going to start seeing liquidity coming out of the economy a little bit, maybe out of the marketplace too. That's when the Fed turns into a net extractor of liquidity as they reinvest less. We have a chance this week to hear some tighter talk from the BOJ. They go tonight, and the ECB, they're on deck for Thursday. All right, I don't think either one of them is actually going to impact policy, but they're both going to probably start leaning in a tighter direction. So we have a tighter monetary, I can't say, it won't be tighter conditions, but it's going to be a little more uncomfortable going forward, which we could get a little dicey for the 10-year here in the U.S., we'll see.
Yeah.
But we have GDP at the end of the week, which is very interesting to a guy like me.
Forecast.
Well, the consensus is about 3.0 right now for the fourth quarter. Atlanta's at 3.2. I think we can come in well above 3.0. I'm kind of excited for this, but I don't want to get too carried away. I don't think it matters all that much, though, because the fourth quarter wasn't part of 2018, and 2018 is going to be improved, at least for the first half. You just heard from the IMF, right? Yeah, this tax reform plan was such a bad idea, it's going to boost global GDP.
Man, well, you know what? Another hot topic with that is Bitcoin, but I think we're going to leave our viewers waiting for us because Sarge and I are going on a little Bitcoin field trip later this week, and we'll have plenty of footage to cover it so you can feel like you're tagging along with us. In the meantime, Stephen, thank you for taking the time always to get on camera with me, and I'll see you later this week.
As always, the pleasure was mine.